Good morning, gentlemen. We're here in Carson off the 405 and Carson off, and we have this I believe it's an X-ray mobile truck that weighs roughly 64,000 pounds, and the driver cut a little too close and came off the off-ramp, and it's about to flip over. Obviously right now the only thing pretty much holding it up is probably that fifth wheel plate and the fact that it's leaning against the asphalt right here, but it's about to go. Let me get you an angle of this this opposite side. Right there where it's digging in. Yep. So Dave and I devised a pretty rather simple plan. Big Flipper's gonna get the rear, swing it over. Dave's gonna go on the opposite side on the on-ramp and run straps from the trailer up just to sustain it while I swing, because it is pretty top heavy. Yeah, because I believe it has a boom. I'll put some pictures in there so you can see this thing telescopes, so it's pretty top heavy. So we'd rather not risk it and lose the truck. We're gonna take extra precaution on this. The walls on that truck seem to be very sturdy, so we'll probably be able to run two straps. The portion in the back is all fiberglass, so it's hollow, so we definitely won't be putting anything there. But right there where you see HCV mobile, it's pretty rigid along with the boom on top, so we'll come up with an ingenious rigging for the truck itself. For the rear, it should be pretty simple. I'm gonna put my frame grab hooks in the back. Lift and swing. I am at a pretty horrible angle on Big Flipper, but Big Flipper should be able to handle it. Coupled with Dave's auxiliary lines from the side, should be able to help me out tremendously. What are you looking for, Dan?
The other license plate.
Oh. What's up, spider?
She says he was all over your ears.
No, he wasn't. He couldn't have been. Did you call him a liar? You did?
If he was all the way over here, there was no way he was gonna go in there.
No, hell no.
He got it right away.
Where am I gonna grab what?
How are you gonna grab it?
How am I gonna grab it?
Yeah.
From the frame grab hooks to the back. They're gonna run a strap high from the top because it's top heavy.
Yeah.
Just to sustain it from coming over.
Right.
And then it's auxiliary lines at the bottom of the trailer to help me as I'm coming over with it.
So you're gonna get it from here?
From here, yeah. Well, not from this one because this one lifts.
Right.
Yeah, I'll be from between those two axles.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir. No, maybe like an hour and a half maybe. The longest time is just going to be rigging just for, because that's pretty top heavy.
Yeah, I was just thinking, we can't just like pull it out and boom.
Yeah, it will come over because it's top heavy. So obviously I'll be swinging it over, but the other truck, the whole purpose of that one is just to run a strap around and some auxiliary lines down to this trailer to stabilize it as I'm swinging it over. That way it doesn't topple over.
Cool. Sounds good.
Thank you, sir. just wrap it through here?
Yeah.
Yeah? Am I gonna put frame hook? Yeah? Okay. No, it's like it's not a lip. It's like this, so it's not even gonna grab. It's gonna be like that. If we pull from here, we could. I'll just put it to a truss right here. ¿Tienes dos?
Huh?
¿Vas a poner uno o dos?
No, two.
Sí, ¿verdad?
The other one's over there.
Oh. You're gonna low sheave these, no?
Huh?
You're gonna low sheave these, right? Yeah, huh?
But it's not even gonna be low sheave, it's right here. It's gonna come up. Like right here. The same as that one, you see?
Yeah. You gotta tie it to itself, or you have those chain clutches? Yeah. Huh? As close as possible. Probably like right here. Huh? Thirteen. Yeah. Yeah, I know. Ah, va a pegar ahí, güey.
¿Ah?
Va a pegar ahí, ¿no? We need like a little extension. What else? Bailey's grommets. Yeah. Y un café, sí. Right there, huh? Why don't we just run our 15 footers across up top?
Well, I don't know what that, how that is on top.
Not that, this. Well, because the whole thing is one, what looks like what's heavy is gonna be where the boom portion's at, where it's on top, the middle. Oh, okay. Which ones?
The round ones.
The round ones are up the up on top.
Top?
Yeah.
Top inside the tunnel box?
Yeah, on the tunnel box. Nah, if we pull on this, it's gonna come forward.
Huh? Yeah.
Yeah, I can see the wear pads already there. The wear pads, that's just where it lands. There's no side hooks. You know how sometimes it falls in and it locks in place? I think where it locks in place is gonna be on the turret somewhere down there.
You don't see anything?
I don't see anything. What's up? I mean, we could run a strap and we could tug on it a little bit, see how it reacts, but I think it's gonna swing.
I don't see why it would swing, boy. That means going down the road.
Well, you know what? We only realistically need one, no?
Yeah.
Just wrap it through the turret right here.
The turret right there?
Yeah, this is a turret. So that is solid down to the frame. Let's wrap it through the turret here. Just give me that...
The extra long
pin? Yeah, the 15 footer. It's on top. Spider, can you pass me that or no? No, I'm not telling Spider. Thank you, Spider. A what?
A ring.
Huh?
I'm gonna put a ring.
Oh, you're gonna put a master link?
I can grab both.
Okay. Well, in that case, put two, no?
Yeah.
Two master links, so that way when you pull on them, or you're gonna put both of them like that? Como quieras. Yeah, just marry your line. Yeah, marry your line. Why? Well. Right now, I'll shoot up the drone.
I'm just gonna hire a photographer.
Just take someone with you?
Yeah.
At all times? Hey, hold on. Before you put pressure, let me put protectors on it, you know? They're in the bucket and that in the, my truck. The tunnel box on the passenger side. The passenger side tunnel box in the bucket. Okay, got it. I got it. Yeah. Huh? Yeah, put tension. Huh? Your boom? Yeah, yeah. Just match the angle with this a little bit. That way we're not putting too much pressure on that. Try right there. Pretty good, no? Woo. You can make the turn there? What happened? Well, he says he can make the, he said he can make the rest of the turn, no? Well, as you can see now, the guy is pretty much out. We brought him all the way over. Now he can make that turn now safely. The load's still intact. And he'll be on his way to deliver the truck. How far are you going?
I'm only 2 miles away. This is my off-ramp for this.
Do you normally take this off-ramp all the time?
No, first time, and in the middle of the night, too.
You couldn't I believe it.
I was waiting because I knew I would hit curb.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't feel nothing. I felt a little bit. Well, where it went off, it was that round part, man. I didn't even feel it. So I was like, oh, I'm good.
And then, yeah. You could see where you slid.
Oh yeah.
Well, you hit right
Once
there?
Hit the ice plant, it just started going.
Yeah, man. It started going. You got no traction.
Dude, I was all the way up against the guardrail. When it totally dug in here, my whole truck just shifted over.
Oh, like, wow.
It almost hopped.
Well, good thing it didn't roll. Because I've seen them roll here before.
I bet. Yeah. One of the officers was telling me we've had problems with this. I said, why are they routing me this way?
Yeah.
Please don't send me this way.
Or they should make it wider, at least 2 lanes. I mean, 3 lanes, I mean. You know?
Something. Yeah, take out the guardrail and give me some room over
see right now. Let me double check if they took care of payment, or if it's a billable call, then you could just take off. Give me like a couple minutes though.
Yeah, you loaded me a couple times with those airport.
You know what? Tanks. I remember. Yes, I remember now. Okay. Yeah, you're right. You seem familiar.
Unfortunately, we get to meet this way. That's what I told one of the other guys. I said, I never thought I'd be the guy that needs recovery. Yeah. I did towing for years.
It happens to everybody, man.
Roll forward real slow.
Yeah, go ahead.
I just want to get on level ground.
No worries.
The weight to leave.
Okay.
So,
leaning bad, huh?
Yeah. The load itself, huh?
Yeah.
Care about that lead?
Yeah.
It's been that way the whole trip, man.
No way, really?
It's that off center, yeah.
Oh. I guess it's been like that, he said.
It's actually traveled really well.
Oh. How did they load you? It drove?
Drove it on.
Oh, okay. You're backed up, are you?
Yep. I don't see nothing broken back there.
No.
This was off the ground like that rear part. It was lower than the other side, but
yeah.
The beam's not broken.
No, the weight is definitely on this side, because you could see it, it's pretty much even, but. Let me start cleaning up back here right now, come. It's leaning, huh? Thank you. What happened, sir?
You'll be able to just back all the way down, you think?
Yeah, I think I'll be able to back up.
Just back and go, well, that other street's called Recreation, so we just back up. We'll hold the intersection, just go through, and then you can...
Okay. I'll probably get on and turn around over there. Okay. Oh, where's the entrance for this one back here? For Carson?
Do you want to go northbound?
No, I want to go back. Yeah, southbound. Yeah.
Southbound? So you back up through and you'll make go back underneath.
Underneath, right?
So okay. You back all the way up and then you make a left turn.
Okay. I'll do that. Just let me get this dirt out of the way.
Instead of trying to stop the whole freeway and everything else.
Oh, yeah, no, it's better this way. No, huh? Thank you, sir. Appreciate the help. I shoveled pretty much all the dirt that was on the road. I'll let Caltrans take care of the rest, but we're pretty much set here. Dave's putting away his truck now. Clipper's pretty much put away. He's gonna back up on the on-ramp and call it a day. All right, guys. From Carson, peace out.